Good morning, students. In the previous lecture, we started the directive principles of state policy. And in today's lecture, we will continue that topic and also do the few more topics which are left from this chapter. And this is the last lecture for chapter 2. As you know, the directive principles of state policies are guidelines for the government for doing better society. Now we will do relationship between fundamental rights and directive principles. We will compare these two topics. First of all, fundamental rights. Fundamental rights are protected by the mainly protect the right of individuals. Means fundamental rights emphasize on the individual's rights. He or she is getting the rights or not. In spite of that, directive principles are emphasize on the well-being of whole society. Means all the citizens of the society are getting the good environment or not. Second difference, protected by the court. Fundamental rights are protected by the courts. Means if anybody does not get the rights, he or she can go to court. But directive principles are guidelines for the government. If government are not following the directive principles, nobody can go to court. Third difference, these holds back the government from doing certain things. Means fundamental rights कुछ restrictions put on the citizens, sorry, put on the government to control few things, but directive principles extends or guides the government to do few more things for well-being of society. Goals of directive principles. Welfare of the people, as we studied earlier, welfare of the people of the society. Social, economic and political justice are the main goals of the directive principles, and many other goals are looking on the screen. And policies of directive principles under which they work. Uniform civil code. Prohibition of consumption of alcoholic liquor, promotion of cottage industries, and etc. are the main policies under which directive principle works. Non-justiciable rights of directive principles. Before we study this, I'll explain the non-justiciable means. Non-justiciability refers to limits upon legal issues over which a court can exercise its judicial authority. State courts also have rules requiring matters brought before them to be justiciable. In simple words, we can say directive principles are non-justiciable rights, like they can just guide to the government. Equal pay for equal work among the men and women, right against economic exploitation, right to work, right of children to free and compulsory education. As a citizen, we expect many more rights from the government, and we demand all these rights must be provided by the governments to the citizens. Along with this feature, our constitution has put certain duties on citizens also. Means if citizens are getting the rights, so they have to perform certain duties. And duties are not mentioned in the beginning or not provided by the Constituent Assembly. On later stage, it was put or amended in the constitution. There are 10 duties in the constitution. The fundamental duties were included in 1976 by 42nd amendment. And for example, few fundamental duties I am explaining: abide by the constitution, defend our country, promote harmony among all citizens, protect the environment. Last topic of this chapter is the right to property. As you know, we have studied all the fundamental rights which are provided by constitution to the citizen of India, in which the right against exploitation, we end the article 30. And the last fundamental right started with article 32. So, article 31 was left. Now, you can ask the question, why and how? In the beginning, or we can say at the time of constitution framing, our constituent assembly put the right to property in the list of fundamental rights and also provided for this article 31. But in the later stage, our government thought this was not to be according to the spirit of fundamental rights. So, they have changed and amended the constitution. In the constitution, originally, there was a fundamental right to acquire, possess the main and maintain property. But the constitution means it clear that property could be taken away by the government for public welfare. After a long debate in 1973, the Supreme Court gave a decision that the right to property was not part of the basic structure of the constitution, and therefore parliament had power to abridge this right by an amendment. In 1978, the 44th amendment to the constitution removed the right to property from the list of fundamental rights and converted it into a simple legal right under article 300. I hope all the points are clear to you. If you face any problem, you can ask to me or you can re-attend the lectures. And also, after this lecture, you will get the assignment of chapter 2. You must listen all the lectures carefully. After that, you will able to attempt the assignment. Thank you and have a nice day.